Friends, in your home, even after connecting MCB, the electrical devices in your home sometimes burn out. Whereas we connect MCB so that electrical devices in our home remain protected. So what is the problem behind this, that this MCB is unable to protect the devices in our home? This is going to be discussed through this video. So this video is going to be highly informative for you. Please watch till the last. Friends, first of all, let me tell you about this MCB. MCB provides two types of protection. First one is from short circuit. Second is from overload. It means if high current flows through this MCB, then this MCB you have will trip. Similarly, the wiring done in your home, if short circuit happens in wiring, then in this condition also MCB will trip. Now here in this MCB, if you look above the MCB here, current rating is written. Like in this MCB, here it is written 63. This means this MCB will trip at 63 ampere. If current flows below this value, this MCB will not trip. Now this MCB is connected in our home at the time of wiring. I mean at the time of wiring of home, this MCB is installed. At the time of installation of MCB, this rating here, we have to take care of this rating. Just few days ago, I heard a complaint from a person that wiring in his home completely burned out. Why wiring is completely burned in his home? Let's discuss this for now. When I went to his house and checked the wiring, then I found that wiring done in his home is done only by two wires. One is phase supply wire and another is neutral supply wire. By using only two wires, if wiring is done in your home, then burning of wires is expected. Here chances of burning of wire is increased. Why this has happened, let's understand. Friends, the devices in our home, that is electrical device, are of two types. First one is lighting. Second one is of power consuming, that is load. In lighting one, we connect bulb or fan used in our home is connected. In power or load one, we consider geyser, mixer grinder, along with this cooler, refrigerator. I mean all those appliances through which heavy current flows, we call these as power load. When we go for wiring in our home, then at the time of wiring, you have to do two kind of wiring. First one is lighting wiring, second one is power wiring. So all the bulbs in your home as well as all the fans will receive the power supply through lighting circuit. Whereas the heater or any other device you connect wherever in home, the socket installed for these connections, this socket will receive power supply through power circuit. To the home where I went to check the wiring, I found the problem in their home is in wiring of their home. Only one circuit is used in wiring. Apart from this, I found a second problem also, that the MCB used in their home, that only single MCB was used there and rating was 32 ampere. You can see right now I also have 32 ampere MCB. So only this MCB is installed in their home. Now through this single MCB, if I run the whole load, then this MCB will provide proper protection. I mean when this much load is running, the current will be around 20 ampere or it can be 25 ampere. This will be the highest. So if the whole load is running, then this MCB will provide the protection. But as we know, devices in our home like geyser, cooler, mixer, refrigerator, not always used. Only sometimes we need to turn on and off these devices. So these devices are turned on and off only sometimes. Normally on MCB, the load is of bulbs and fans. If you turn on all the bulbs and fans in your home, then maximum 1 ampere to 2 ampere current will flow through MCB. For only 1 to 2 ampere current, if you install the MCB of 32 ampere, then how you are going to get protection? Your MCB will not trip till the current flowing through the MCB goes beyond 32 ampere. So when you are going for wiring of your home, you have to keep two things in mind. First of all, the wiring which is going to be done in your home, you have to use two circuits there. First circuit is for lighting and second one is for power load. After this, for the protection of devices in your home, the MCB which you are going to use, the rating of that MCB should be proper. To find out the required rating of MCB, a calculation is needed. If you don't want to go for calculation, there is also a simpler way. If only 2 to 3 rooms are there in your home, then you can use 6 ampere MCB for lighting circuit. This means the power supply which goes to lighting circuit, in this you have to connect 6 ampere MCB. After this, for power circuit, you have to connect 16 ampere MCB. If you have more rooms in your home, then you can use more MCBs separately. Suppose there are 6 rooms in your home, then what you can do, for 3 rooms install 1 MCB and for another 3 rooms install 1 MCB. This means you have to use total 2 MCBs for 6 rooms. So you have to take care of these two things whenever you go for wiring of home. Apart from this, if you go to purchase MCB in market, then same as MCB, you will find an isolator also. If you don't have the knowledge of electrical, then you will never come to know that the MCB which you bought from market is not MCB, it is isolator. What is isolator? I will make another video to explain you about this. For now, remember only one thing, that the MCB will provide you the overload and short circuit protection. But if you buy isolator, then it will not provide any kind of protection. So when you go to buy this MCB, you must see one thing, that above the MCB, this type of symbol must be present. Above the MCB, if this type of symbol is there, then you can buy this. If this symbol is not there and only this type of symbol is present there, then don't buy this one. This is a symbol of isolator. So these 3 points that I told you, if you remember these 3 points and go for wiring of your home and installing MCB, then devices in your home will get complete protection. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, give like on my video. If you are new to the channel, subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching this video.